Welcome. In this video, we will see how to use the radio buttons in MATLAB GUI. So for that, we have to open guide. So here we have to select this blank GUI and click on OK. So it will open this GUI environment. Here we can create our own GUI. Okay. In the previous videos, we have seen how to use push button, axis and slider. Okay. So now we will see how to use the radio buttons. Okay. So this is the radio button. So I'll just click on it and drag and drop it on the layout. Okay. So I will take one more button and one more. So total three buttons I have taken. Now, okay. So now what we'll do is we'll save this with some name, for example, demo radio. So this M file is generated for that GUI. So we'll again switch back to this layout. So here now, if I click on this run button, the GUI will run, right? And here you can see the three buttons are there and I can click on all these three buttons. But generally what should happen is out of these three at a time, only one radio button should be selected. But in this case, all the three buttons are selected. Okay. So for that, we have to make a different arrangement. So I will show you how to do that. Okay. So I will close this. So for that purpose, we have to take this another component called as button group. Okay. So I'll just again click it, drag it and drop it on the layout. Okay. So using this button group, we can group all these buttons together. So because of that, at a time only one button will get selected. Okay. So I'll place these buttons in this button group. Okay. Now if I save it and if I run it, now you can see at a time only one radio button is getting selected. Okay. So this is how the GUI should work, right? Now what I want to do is I want to create a GUI such that whenever this radio button is selected, at that time the message should be displayed over here that which radio button you have selected. Okay. So for that I will just change the names of these radio buttons. So for that we have to go to string. Okay. So here this is the name for that radio button. So what I will do, I will just put the name as radio button 1 and I will keep this tag same as it is without any change. Just I will increase the font. Okay. So I will make it 14. Okay. So next one, again, I will put here name as radio button 2 and again font as 14. Then this one as radio button 3 and again font as 14. So these three buttons I have created. Okay. Okay. Now I will go to this buttons group. So for that, double click on that and here is the string button group. So I will change it to, let's say, selection. Okay. And I will give the tag as select radio. So now this button groups can be used for selecting a particular radio button and giving some output. Now to display the output, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a static text box. Okay. So which is available over here. So I will drag it and drop it on the layout. I will double click on this and I will enter some text over there. Like you selected. Okay. So this is the static text. Another box I will take of static text and place it in front of this box. Okay. And now again, I will double click on this and I will remove this static text. And here the tag name I will give as, let's say, selected button. And I will also change the font. Let's see, 14. Right. So what I want to basically do is whenever I run this GUI and if I select any of these buttons, which button I have selected, that should be displayed here in this static text box. Okay. So that is the task that I want to perform. So to identify which button is selected out of these three, we have to go to this buttons group, click on view callbacks and select this selection changed function, because whenever we change the selection, at that time this function will be called. Okay, so this is that select change function. So to identify which button is selected, for that we have to write a command. For example, let us say A is equal to get, and here we have to give the handles to that buttons group. Okay, so handles dot, we have to write here the tag name of this buttons group, so it is displayed over here, that is select radio. So select radio, so that is the tag name. Okay, then comma, and in single inverted quotes we have to type selected object, right? So this gives us the structure of the selected object for that buttons group. Now to exactly find out which button is pressed or which button is selected, I can write here a dot string, right? So now what I will do, I will just click on save and I will run this GUI. Okay, so if I click here, you can see here radio button 2 is selected. We get the messages radio button 2 is selected. If I click this, then we get messages radio button 3 selected. If I click on this, I get messages radio button 1 selected, right? So with this I will get which button is selected. Now what I have to do, I have to get that value and display it over here, okay, in the static text box. Okay, so I'll again close this. So here after this I can instruct this, or I will use the command set handles dot. Now I have to select the tag name of the static text box which is present over here, so it is selected button. Okay, so selected button. Okay, then here I can write comma. Okay, and then I can change the property. Now to check that, you can simply double click on this and you can check here, we have to select this string property, right? So in this code I can write here in single inverted quotes string. Okay, and what value I have to put there, I have to put the value of the button that is selected, so that is available as a dot string. Okay, so let us save this and run this. So you can see here, when I click on this radio button 2, here you selected radio button 2. If I click here, you selected radio button 3. If you click here, it gives the messages radio button 1 selected. Okay, so in this way we can identify which button is selected. Okay, one more thing that you might have observed is, I will again close this and run it again. So here default the radio button 1 is selected. Okay, but initially none of the buttons should be selected, right? So for that I have to modify the program slightly, right? So as soon as the GUI runs, it executes this function, that is opening function. Okay, so here I have to write a command to deselect the radio button, right? So by default radio button 1 is selected, so I have to use the command set handles dot. Now I want to modify the status of the first radio button because it is the default selected radio button, so the tag name for the radio button 1 is handles dot radio button 1. Okay, comma, again I want to modify its value, so for that again I can go to that radio button 1. If you double click on this, you will get the value. Okay, so here value is 1, it means that it is selected. Okay, so in the program I can write here the property as value, so in single inverted quotes value, and what value I want to set, I want to deselect it, so the value should be 0. Okay, so now I will save it and again run it. So you can see that none of the button is now selected. Now if I click on this, you will get here you selected radio button 1. If I click here, you will get message as you selected radio button 2. And if I click here, you will get the message as radio button 3, right? So in this way, we can make use of these radio buttons for creating in some sort of GUI. Thank you.